students, so we are in chapter 7 and in that we are discussing part 1, that is working with OpenOffice Cal. Okay, wow. So already we have completed the theoretical part for you, and by now we are going to discuss the practical session for OpenOffice Cal, that is your part 1. Yes, now we can enter. So you people know what is the step that you people have to follow to open OpenOffice Cal. It is more or less similar to that of the OpenOffice Writer. Yes, now we can proceed. Yes, what are the steps that you people have to follow? Yes, you have to click Start. Then you have to click All Programs. Yes, then you have to click OpenOffice. Yes, below that you people are having the all the things. Already we have completed OpenOffice Writer, and now we are going to proceed with OpenOffice Cal. Just you people click this one. Yes, your screen is displayed for you. Okay, wow. So you people are able to see the screen. Your screen is displayed for you. Yes, now first we can see how to open a... just now we finished how to open OpenOffice Cal. In that we have opened a document also. So here this doc, it will not be called as a document for you. It will be called as a spreadsheet, that is worksheet. It is called as your worksheet. Okay, wow. So again, if you people are willing to open a new, what you people have to do? You have to click File, New. Okay, wow. Yes, here you people are having a spreadsheet. Just click this one. Yes, your new spreadsheet will be opened for you. So in OpenOffice Cal, what do you people have to tell? You have to tell it as spreadsheet and not as a document. So document only and a writer. Okay, wow. So now we can proceed with this one. Yes, first we can discuss about the parts of the window. First we can discuss about the parts of the OpenOffice Cal window. Yes, first one, it is your title bar. So in the beginning you people are having, no, it is your title bar. So you people are able to see, so it is having the name as untitled one, and next it is having its application name, that is your OpenOffice Cal. Okay, wow. So since this worksheet or the spreadsheet is not saved for you, it is displayed as untitled one. So after saving this one, automatically it will be changed. What the name that you people have given, that will be replaced instead of untitled one. And next it is your application name, that is your OpenOffice Cal. And to this side, what you people are having? Yes, this is your minimize, this is your maximize or the restore button, and this is your close button. Okay, wow. So these three are called as your control buttons. These three are called as your control buttons. So first one, it is your title bar. And next you people are having the next one, it is your menu bar. Next it is your menu bar. So under that menu bar, what else you people are having? Yes, you people are having the file. Next you people are having edit. Yes, first we can see about the each and every menu. In that first we can have the file. Okay, wow. Yes, under file, what else we are having? Yes, just you people click this one. Yes, you are having new, open, recent documents, wizards, close, save us, and each and everything you people are having. So as a whole, you people can tell these are your file management tasks. So what are the tasks that are related to the file management? Everything are displayed here. And next you people are having the edit. Under that, what else you people are having? Yes, you are going to have the editing commands like cut, copy, paste, that and all you will be having under edit menu. And the next menu, it is your view menu. View menu, it is going to contains the commands which are used to modify the environment. So here you people can have a normal, otherwise your page break is needed. Now, yes, you people can have similarly for full screen, zoom, everything, just to have a view. By the name itself, you people must be clear. Now, so to view the document, how it must be, everything is you people can sit under this menu. And next one, it is your insert. So here what and all you people are going to have? Yes, you are having cells, rows, column, sheet, yes, function list, like a picture, everything. What else you people are willing to insert? Everything is available under this menu. And the next it is your format. So what and all you are having under format? Yes, format cells, row, column, yes, sheet, like it change case. Yes, everything is here for you. It is your format. And next one, it is your tools. Yes, what else available here? Spelling, language, autocorrect, SL contents, gallery, like this it's going on. So that and all seen under tools for you. And next one, yes. Yes, next it is your data. So under the data menu, what else we are having? Yes, we are having some commands to manipulate this manipulate the data that is available in the spreadsheet. That is, you people can perform sort, filter, total, validity checking. So what else checking that you people can do? Everything you people can do by means of this menu. Okay, ba? So see that under that, what else you are having? You are having defined range, select range, sort, filter. Yes, each and everything you are having here for the purpose of performing any calculations. And next you people are having the menu. It is your window. So under that, you are having the options like new window, close the window, split, freeze, everything we are having. Okay, va? At last we are having the help. So this help menu supports you or helps you to perform for the what is the available options. If you are having any doubts, means that will be clarified by means of this help menu. So clear with the menu bar. So just now we have completed the first one, it is your title bar, and the next one it is your menu bar. Okay, va? And next you people can move to the next one, it is your toolbar. Here you are having, no, yes, this one. So this one and this one, these are the toolbars for you. First we can discuss the first one. Yes, under the toolbar, in worksheet, that is in OpenOffice Calc, we are having three types of toolbar. We are having three types of toolbar. Okay, va? So the first one, it is your standard toolbar. Next one, it is your formatting toolbar. And the next one, it is your formula bar. So here we are having three types of toolbars. Yes, what is the first one? It is your standard toolbar. So see here, the first line, it is your standard toolbar, and the next one it is your formatting toolbar, and here and this one it is, and this one it's your formula bar. Okay, va? So first line, this is your standard toolbar, and next one it is your, yes, it is your formatting toolbar. Here we are performing bold, italic, underline, alignment and all we are having, no? So this is your formatting toolbar, and this line it is your formula bar. Okay, va? And this one it is your formula bar. So here we are having three types of toolbar. So you people know what is a standard toolbar. Yes, here it is going to have the icons for save. Here you are having, no, save, then open, file new, print, preview, spell check, cut, copy, paste. Here everything you are having for standard. So under the formatting also you are having for font. This is your font size, bold, italic, underline. These are for your alignment. Similarly, so here we are going to deal with the numbers, no, for that currency conversion. Everything you people are having here. Color change, everything that are available under formatting toolbar. And next line you people are having this one. This is your formula bar. So first two are more or less equal to that of the writer also. And the third one only, it is the most important thing for OpenOffice Calc. Okay, va? Yes, what here in the formula bar, we are going to have four parts. Here we are having four parts. The first one, it is your name box. That is name box, or it is your address box. And next two people will be having function wizard, sum button, then function button and input line. Okay, va? So here you people are having the first one. That is your A1, no? So this is your address. It is showing your address box, or it is your name box. Okay, va? So next, if you are having FX like, no, so this is your functions. This is your function. So summation like you are having, no, summation is nothing but it is your sum. Yeah, by pressing this one, you people can perform the addition. So it is your sum. And next you people are having a equal to symbol, no, so that is your function button. And next you people are having a continuous line like this, no, this is your input line. This is your input line. Okay, ma? So these are the four important things that are available in your formula bar. So why you people are having the name box? Already I told you, it is just going to display the address for you. Okay, va? The next FX is nothing but it is used to insert some functions. Some button, yes, just to, if you are willing to add anything immediately or very in a quick way, if you are willing to insert a sum function, means just you people click that one. Next you people are having a equal to, yes, to perform any calculation, it must in OpenOffice Calc, that is in the case of spreadsheet, it must always begin with the equal to symbol. So only you are having the equal to there. And next, you people are having a input box, that is your input line. Here only you people are going to type the formula. Type the formula, or what else you people are going to select, everything will be displayed there only. So clear with this one. So just now we have completed title bar, menu bar, then toolbars. So how many types of toolbars are there? Three. What are they? Standard toolbar, formatting toolbar, and the next one, it is your formula bar. So clear with the till now, what else we have discussed? Yes, next we can have the next part of this window, that is your scroll bar. That is your scroll bar. So two types of scroll bars are there. That is your horizontal scroll bar, and next one, it is your vertical scroll bar. Okay, wow. So this side you are having the vertical. People are able to see the changes. Yes, this is your vertical and this is your scroll horizontal. So horizontal, it is used to move the page from which side to which side, that is left side to right side. Then it is your vertical is from moving from top to bottom. If you are going to work with a large amount of data, instead of moving the cursor for each and every step, you people can use the scroll bars. Similarly, there you people are having a scroll button. Yes, this is, you will be having a scroll buttons. Why the scroll buttons are used? Yes, to certain distance, for limited distance, if you people are willing to move means, then you people can use the scroll button. So this is your scroll button. So three lines like you people are having, no? So that is your scroll button. To this side also you will be having, and to this side also you will be having. So three lines like you are having, no? So that is your scroll button. So clear with this one. Yes, next we can see inside. So this is your workspace that we have discussed in Writer. So in this area, in this, that is in Cal, it will be called as your spreadsheet. Already I told you, okay, bah. So here you people are having many cells. Here we are having many cells. Here only we are going to perform the each and every task that we are going to do, okay, bah. Yes, first we can see the first line. Yes, first line we are having row. That is, we are having A. Just you people see the screen. Just the term A and 1 are enlightened for you. That just the term A and the next one, number 1, is enlightened for you. So immediately you people see here. So just now I told you it is your address. So here address is displayed. That is A1 is displayed. Similarly, I am moving to the next one. Now see the address. It is B1 is displayed for here. Here you are having B1. So B1 is displayed. Come to the next line. So immediately B2 is displayed for you. Okay, wow. So by this, you people will be able to understand. So what is the address? Address is nothing but it is just the combination of row and column. Just the combination of row and column. So this line vertically you people are having, no? Each and everything are called as your columns. Horizontal are called as your rows. So to identify the column, it is alphabetically numbered for you, starting from A until the sequence goes on for you people. So what is the range? Now I will tell you, okay, va? So starting from A, the range goes for you. So for, it is for your column. So consider the row, it is numbered for you. So column is alphabetically numbered and the row is numbered. That is starting from 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that, it will be going on for you, okay, va? So the combination of row and the column will give the address for you. Now you people see here, and by now you people see the address bar, it is D5. So just the term D and 5 is enlightened for you, okay, wow. So by means of this, you people can find out the address in which place now you people are. So here, now I am moving, no? So here, a black rectangular box is moving for you, no? So that rectangle box is called as your cell pointer. The black rectangle box is called as your cell pointer. So able to see this one? I'm just moving it around the worksheet for you people. So it is your cell pointer. Okay, ma'am. Cell pointer. So why this cell pointer is in need for you people? Yes, to move from one box, that is your one box to another, you people are in need of this one. Similarly, if I am here, that is now I am in which address? Yes, I am in E. 10. So this cell is called as your active cell. This cell is called as your active cells. And now I am going to type something here. So type some values or to perform some calculation, I am going to use this one. So this is called as your active cell. In which cell I am going to type something means that is called as my active cell. Okay, va? So don't forget, the rectangular black rectangular box is called as your cell pointer. And which cell I am, the pointer is, the cell pointer is here, no? So this cell is called, now E14 is called as your active cell. Similarly, if I am moving here, which is the active cell for me? Yes, K15 is the active cell for me. Okay, va? So clear with what is a cell, what is a cell address, and what is a cell pointer? Everything, you people are clear? People are able to understand the introduction that are related to worksheet, everyone? Yes, here. Just now I told you it begins with A for you, the alphabet A. And it ends with, yes, based upon the versions that we are having, it ends for you. Okay, wow. Yes. So in the case of OpenOffice Calc, that is version 4.1.5, you will be having 1024 columns. You will be having columns 1024. That it is, it ends with alphabet AMJ. Here it begins with alphabet A and it is going to end with alphabet AMJ. Okay, va? So in the screen you people are able to see A, B, C, D till we are able to see P. So finally, end of the screen, you people will be having AMJ. So to the next thing I will be moving for you. That's all. Okay, va? If you are moving now, it will be going on. So see here, AJ, AK, like that, it will be moving on. So the end, it will be AMJ. Similarly, in the case of row also, we are having, it starts from 1 for you. And it is going to end with 10. That is, it is 10,48,576 rows we are having. Okay, wow. So it's just down. I will scroll down for you people able to see. So just now we are having 174. Okay, but 200. Like that it will be going on till 10,48,576. Till that we are having the rows are numbered for you. So clear with what is a row, what is a column, and what is a active cell, how you will be getting the cell address, and what is a cell. Everything you people are clear? Yes, next we can move on to the next one. That is your worksheet tab. That is your worksheet tab. Yes, just now we are going to see here. Below, you people come here, able to see this one. Here we are having sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Okay, wow. As a whole, it is your worksheet. In this worksheet, we are having in default 3 sheets will be available for you. So now we are using sheet 1. So see the difference between this one and the remaining 2. Able to see the difference? This is your sheet 1. It is slightly enabled for you. Remaining 2 are like disabled for you. Able to see the difference? Yes, now see. So this is your sheet 2. Now we are in sheet 2. This is your sheet 3. Okay, wow. Sheet 1. Now we are in sheet 1. Similarly, so these are your sheet tabs. These are called as your sheet tabs. If you people are willing to change the name, yes, you people can change. How you people can do? Just you people right click. Here you will be having rename sheet. Similarly, you can insert another sheet also. Just I am clicking here. Yes, so before the current sheet or after the current sheet, so new sheet, how many sheets, name, everything is asked here. So just we will fill this one and click OK. Yes, now we are having sheet 4 here. Why I am having here? So while I am entering itself, I mentioned, so it must be before the current one. So sheet 4 is here. Next I am having sheet 1. Like that it is going on for me. So now I am going to change the name. Now I am going to delete this one. How I can? Yes, click delete sheet. Yes, it is asking for the confirmation. Next, yes. Yes, that said, that sheet is deleted. Next we can have the next one. It is your rename sheet. Just you people click this one. Yes, and now I am going to rename it as sample. Yes, it is here. Now the first sheet is renamed. Clear with this one? Yes, clear with the sheets that are available. Yes, next you people come to this one here. We are having sheet 1 by 3. So what it is telling for you people in the, so this line is your status bar. Last line we are having, no? So the last line, it is your status bar. It is your status bar. Okay, va. So in that it is showing the count. How many sheets are there? And now we are in which street? Now we are in first sheet. Totally how many sheets are there? 3 sheets. So now I am clicking the sheet 2 means, yes, see here, the sheet 2 of third. So totally 3 sheets are there. Now I am in the second sheet. Like that it will be displayed here for me in the status bar. So here we are having 4 buttons, no? Here we are having 4 buttons. What it is telling for you? So now I am in sheet 3. Okay, va? So just by clicking this one, now I will be in the first sheet. That is, move to the first sheet. Then this one, it is asking people to move to the previous. And this one, moving to the next. And this one, just by clicking this one, you people will be in the last. So first it is your, what is the first for you? Yes, it is your first sheet. It is mentioned, just by clicking this, we can move to the first sheet. So the next one, move to the previous sheet. Next one, move to the next sheet. And next one, it is move to the last sheet. So these are the 4 buttons that you people can have. That is, these 4 can be called as your navigation buttons. These 4 can be called as your navigation buttons. Okay, va? Clear with this one? So finally, we finished this one. That is your status bar. In the status bar, first we finished the count for you. Okay, va? So next we can have the next one. It is your sheet count. So this is your sheet count. Just now we finished. Next we are going to have the page style. Here we are having, no? Yes, next we are having this one. So this is your page style. This is your page style. Here already we are having a term, that is your default. So default is displayed. If you people are willing to perform any changes, yes, so just you people click it here. Yes, the page style dialog box is displayed here for you. Okay, va? So by clicking the page style, so what else changes that you people are willing to do? Yes, you people can change it. So you can change the page. You can change the border. Yes, you can change the background. You people can have the header, footer. And what else changes you people are willing to do in the sheets? Yes, you people can do it. So default is nothing but, it is the default. So already system could have arranged some settings, no? So that it will be. If you people are willing to perform any changes, if you people are willing to perform any changes means, what you people can do? Just you people double click over here. Okay, wow. So then immediately people will be having your page style dialog box. So what else changes you people are willing to do? Yes, you people can perform here. Clear with this one? Yes, next we can have the next one. It is your selection mode. It is your selection mode. Here we are having no STD. 100% is nothing but the way that you people are viewing the screen. That is your 100%. Next, it is your STD. Okay, va? STD is nothing but here the selection mode. Here you people are going to have the selection mode. So totally how many types of selection modes we are having? We are having 3. What are they? Standard, extend. Next, you people can add. Standard, extend. Next, it is your add. So this is your standard. Yes. Next, see here, now it is automatically changed into EXT. That is your extend. Next, standard, extend, like that it will be going on. Based upon the selection that you people are going to perform, the changes will be seen here. Okay, va? So here you people see here, you people are able to see a star symbol. You people are able to see the star symbol. What this star symbol is telling you means, you didn't save this document. You, what else? Sorry. It is your worksheet, no? You should not use the term document. It is your worksheet. So here, the worksheet that you people are currently working is not saved. Okay, va? To tell that only the star symbol is here. So now I am going to save this one. You people know the how to save. That is click file. Next you can save. Yes, you people can select the needed folder and you people can select it. So now I am going to give the name as again sample. Yes, it is automatically saved here. So now open, in the case of OpenOffice worksheet, it is going to have the extension as .ods. Okay, va? It is going to have the extension .ods. So now you will see here, you are not having the star symbol here. You are not having a star symbol here. Okay, va? So just now, before saving the document, before saving the sheet, you are having a star symbol. Now I saved that one. So this, you are not able to see the star symbol. Okay, va? Clear with this one? So just to inform you people, we are having this one. Next, you people see here, you are having sum equal to 0. So it is going to display all the cell information. So what else information, what else calculation that you people are going to perform, everything will be seen in the status bar here for you people. Okay, va? So clear with the status bar. So what else we have discussed in the status bar? First we finished the sheet count, next we finished the page style, next we finish the here selection mode, and next unsaved changes. Okay, va? So quickly clear with the what else we have discussed by today. So first we finish how to open the sheet, then each and every part we have discussed. First it is your title bar, next we finish it is your menu bar, so next it is your toolbox we have finished. That is three types you will be having. First it is your standard toolbar, next one it is your formatting toolbar, and here you will be having the formula bar. So just you people move near itself, it will be helping you people. Below a small yellow box is displayed for you, that is called as your tooltip. So it is automatically telling it is your name box or it is your address box. So now I am here, it is telling it is your function wizard. Next it is your sum. Here you are having equal to, telling it is your function, and here it is your input line. Okay, va? So remaining we can discuss full thoroughly in the next remaining sessions. So this is your introduction class, how to work with worksheet. So this is your the column, how the columns are alphabetically numbered for you, and this side the rows are numbered for you. Okay, va? So here we are having the sheets. So here it is the name of the sheet, we can rename it, we can delete it, we can insert extra sheets, like that it will be going on for you. Similarly here, the first here we are going to have the four navigation buttons. The first one it is used to move to the first sheet, previous sheet, move to the next sheet, and here it is move to the last sheet. So it is your scroll bars. How many types of scroll bars you will be having? Two normally, that is your horizontal and vertical bar. Similarly here you are going to have the scroll buttons also. Okay, va? Next, at last we have discussed the status bar. Here it is going to display the sheet count. Next here you are going to have the page style. Next it is your selection. See here it is your standard. Okay, va? So now you people can insert. So only the insert is displayed here for you. Next here you people will be having the star symbol, that is telling whether you have saved the document or saved this worksheet or not. Similarly here it is cell information will be displayed here for you. Okay, va? So by clicking this one, you people can close it here, or just by clicking file close or file exit here also you are having close. It will close the worksheet alone. So to exit the application, you have to click exit. So clear with the topics, what else we have practically discussed related to the introduction, related to the worksheet? Yes, clear with this one? Yes. Thank you, students.